All right.
So much just recording that song, and sometimes I think it's a shame that the recording that everybody knows is from an afternoon where it was the first time I ever played it, and so it sounds so like naive and green to me when I hear it off the record, but I tell you, I could work on that song forever, for just like decades, to try to get it just right, and I guess you can never get it just right, especially if it's a song that you've invested your heart into. That means it's a growing song, it's a changing song every time you play it, and it sort of gains meaning as you go along. So, you know, but there are little things in there, like, I know this is so minute, but like, I'm up here and I go to play a C sharp and I'm thinking, tonight this is the place, because I want it to have that kind of a sound, I want to be able to shake it and the intonation, but then play it there, and I'll lean over to make sure that my vibrato bar here isn't leaning backwards, and you know, on the guitar, and making it go too sharp and everything. There's like little subtleties that actually cross my mind as I'm playing that, and when I hear those things back, the live recordings, I say to myself, that was a good thing that I locked into that, because it might be that one note that just makes it so perfect, or that one note that reaches that one person in the audience. And so, you know, you have to really take care when you're playing guitar, because it's got so much potential to reach people, you know, especially when you're doing something serious like that. But of course, I'm not always serious like that. Sometimes I'm writing songs just for fun. And I'm going to leave you with a song that's all about having fun. This one's called Satch Boogie.